By now, you've seen how to deploy an edge cluster. In this video, we'll focus on edge cluster operations. What I mean by that is shrinking, expanding, and more importantly, deleting, because that's not as straightforward as the other two. Before we get into it, please like and subscribe if you found my content useful. It really does help me out.
First, we'll go through expansion. In order to do that, you need to go into inventory workload domains, click on the domain, go to edge clusters, and you can see here I've already added another edge node just to test it to make sure it all worked. Now, all you need to do is click on the dots here and click expand edge cluster, and the process is pretty much identical to deploying the edge cluster. You just have to add the specifications of the edge node and then hit go and it will build. You want to make sure that all the BGP peering config and all that sort of stuff upstream is configured to allow for the new edge node, so that way it can be built and it won't fail during the workflow. I won't go through this again because it's almost identical to the actual just edge cluster build. If you want to do that, that's how you do it. And keep in mind, all of the stuff I'm showing you now can be done via API as well. I'll show you now where to find those API. If you go into Developer Center, go to API Explorer, and all the stuff you can do for edge clusters, you'll be able to find these. NSXT edge clusters, all the different things you can do, expand or shrink, it's all here. Just keep in mind that this is here, but we will cover the Developer Center and APIs in its own video later on in this course. Okay, so let me just go back here. I'll go back to the edge clusters. I've shown you how to expand. Now to shrink, all you need to do is, again, the same thing. Select the edge node you want to shrink out, hit next, and hit next. Finish. We'll try to validate to make sure everything's okay to do so. And then once that's done, hit finish. So I won't do that now because it will take a bit of time, and we'll go straight to deleting the edge cluster. But just before we do that, let me show you everything that it's created. We did sort of touch on this earlier, but I'll do it again. T0 gateway, T1 gateway, segments for upstream peering. It also creates the edge node in vCenter, deploys the OVF, and wires it correctly. In the T0 gateway, we've also got BGP peering configuration. So we can see that it's set the correct AS. It's got neighbors set, the two upstream top rack switches. And then if you click on the little eye here, you can see the edge nodes are all established. Perfect, so that's quick and easy. That's how we deploy edge clusters in VCF or SDDC Manager. Now I want to show you how to delete an edge cluster, because as you saw over here, there's no option to delete. So how do we do that? There's a KB article that has been written up for this. I won't make you read all of that, but essentially all you need to do is download this tar, unzip it, upload it to SDDC Manager, which I've already done, and I'm not going to take you through because that's relatively easy. So you can use something like WinSCP once it's extracted, or and upload that to SDDC Manager, or upload the tar and extract it on SDDC Manager directly. Up to you which way you go about it. But let me just bring up SDDC Manager. Once I've SSH'd in as the VCF account, it brings me to this prompt. We do need to SU to root. I've already uploaded the bundle and extracted it. And we should be able to see it in this folder. Extracts from the tar GZ archive into a, extracts the folder called cleanup. So if you go to the cleanup folder, what we need to look at, we open up the contents. We've got this shell script here, which we need to run that will then go and remove or basically reverse everything that's been deployed through SDDC Manager. To run, we'll do this. This is the command you've got to run. You call the script, the users, the administrator of the SSO account for vCenter, pass it for the account, and then the name of the cluster. To figure out which what the name of the cluster is, if we just go back here, we can see the name of the cluster right there. Okay, so if I hit enter on this, it should do an assessment and then prompt to say you wanted to go ahead. It's running the script, yes, and it'll start the cleanup process. Right, so that is done, and in reality, it only took 2 to 3 minutes, so it was a lot shorter than I thought it would be. Let's quickly go back into SDDC Manager, see what it's done, and also NSXT Manager. This is actually what was already there. It just hasn't been refreshed, so let's refresh. So the edge cluster from there has gone. If we go back into NSX, again, this hasn't been refreshed. So let's go to segments. Those two uplink port groups, or segments, I should say, are now gone as well. We've got the T1 gateway also removed, T0 gateway removed. And then if we go to system fabric nodes, also gone. Now let's check vCenter. Close on that. Also gone. There you go. So the script goes and rips out pretty much everything that's deployed as part of the edge cluster develop or deployment.
By now, you should be comfortable with performing operations on your edge clusters. It's relatively simple and there's nothing overly complicated, but you do need to know this stuff. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you missed the deployment of the edges, click on this video. But if you missed the bigger picture and architecture of VCF, check out this video, as it does help you piece it all back together. Catch you next time.